All right, opening hand for round three, we have not very good. In the right matchup, I would definitely keep a double fulminator hand. But we're also on the draw, and we're in the dark, so I think I have to mulligan this. Not great, but I think I have to keep this when we're down to six already. So with this type of hand, I really like to verdant right away to thin, which actually does matter with this deck. Yeah, I guess I feel like that's what we have to do. Rather, it is correct. Kind of wish I kept my opening seven, but definitely. I think it was right to mulligan, unless we know the matchup. Definitely wish I kept it now that I know the matchup, but oh well. Didn't play around Shadow of Doubt. Well, I guess that's okay. We have a lot of lands, and this game is going long. Is it going long enough that I just search for Godless Shrine right now? Sure, my mana is pretty good. I'll play Cliffs to keep him in the dark for another turn. So, he could have Click. Doesn't really matter. I'm just thinking, do I thin before I cycle, which is probably a yes. Go ahead and get a basic here, because my life total actually does matter in this matchup, where you can get burned out from pretty high life totals. I think we're going to save this recluse to actually cast. Cycle these two. And this is one of those times where you might actually not mind having Dryad Arbor, but actually, it's possible. But, I mean, I'm not going to run it anyway. There's zero chance. Not zero chance, but there's a low chance that he doesn't just counter it. Alright, I guess we're going to cast that guy. Yeah, double Fulminator. Would have been a fine hand in this matchup. So the nice thing about the way this deck is built is that none of the cards die to Lightning Bolt except for just the two Abominations, which still don't often die to Lightning Bolt or Helix. And then also, our reach creatures can prevent Colonnade from doing any damage. Yep, that's a spider for sure here. I could Catacombs for Swamp to thin. But, you know, Path actually isn't completely irrelevant here. He could still have mana leaks. You know, when we're casting these cards, it costs so much mana. We could get all the way up to 9 and still. It could still be okay to have another land. Electrolyze into Bolt or Helix. So we're just slowly depleting his resources until we can attempt to resolve a Living End. Sure. I I think I'd rather play Street Wraith first. It's actually not really clear. Like, Street Wraith is going to get trumped by Resto. Jungle Weaver. Either one could get mana leaked, actually, here. If I was going to cycle one of these, I'd rather it be Jungle Weaver to save some life. So I think I'll actually just cast the Street Wraith. So the only thing I'm really worried about besides Cryptic Command, obviously, is Revelation, which is what he has. So went from being in, like, you know, parity to now we're really far behind. Yeah, I don't think we can win. But there's always the possibility that he has just no Cryptic Commands, I guess. And then eventually maybe we can win. Probably getting Resto plus Burn Spell. No? Okay. Well, I could pull the trigger on double Demonic Dread. Five creatures in the graveyard. Could he actually have double Cryptic Command? Well, I guess he would only have to have Mana Leak here, right? Cryptic Mana Leak. So maybe we'll just cast this. Yeah, or we could have had Cryptic Snapcaster leak. So I'm gonna continue playing the long game. It's electrolyzing me. I have a feeling that I'm gonna meet a flurry of burn spells pretty soon. Through the swamp. Fantastic. Yeah, I guess I have to do it. So if he has double cryptic, then whatever. Would have been nice to have a Fulminator Mage at any point in this game. Could have dealt with this double cryptic and then done a lot more too post Living End, but nope. Okay, he's deliberating. So this could resolve. If it does, I think we couldn't really lose unless he has Supreme Verdict. If he has like Path, Snapcaster, Path, and another Path, we still have, I think, three guys. Or he just has Cryptic Command. I don't know why he's slow rolling. Yep, that was a pretty big slow roll. Like I said, I didn't have to concede. I could have drawn another copy. But, you know, he had Snapcaster Mage at that point, so it would have been very, very hard for me to win. Alright, so two collectors, Living End, Avalanche Riders, maybe Beast Within, Dharmi Raid. Shriek Maw come out this time. Probably not bringing in that other Beast Within. In fact, the only real reason it's in the sideboard is probably for Tron, and maybe just if I see specific cards like Leyline. So three more cuts. So I think this is where I usually cut one dread, and then a combination of these. In this matchup, I think it's Twisted Abomination that leaves, yeah. Though Supreme Verdict is a reason to keep that in. Still dies to Path. And it doesn't block Colonnader, you know, Resto or Click like that does. And, you know, it could die to a Bolt, so has ups and downs, but I think I'll cut the Abomination. So I think this is fine. 27 creatures, 4 copies of Living End, and 7 Cascade spells. I'm not sure cutting a Cascade spell is correct when I'm actually bringing in the 4th Living End. And then they also have Vendilion Click, so I think I'll cut either Beast Within or Recluse for the Dread again. I'll do a Beast Within. Beast Within basically just worse than Fulminator Mage and Avalanche Riders. Being an instant, though, it does have some times that it could be better. But also, I'd like to keep my creature count high for Domri, and then Recluse, I think, is just a good card in the matchup, whether you're casting it or cycling it. Though, this, you know, the Stone Rain factor is actually pretty big in this matchup. Oftentimes, they're not going to see it coming, and then it lets you resolve a Cascade spell. But hopefully we could just draw the ones we have. And he has gone the entire 3 minutes without sideboarding, apparently.